5 o'clock challenge match, set for one fall. A virtual ring rest from Aberdeen, Washington, weighing 210 pounds, Daniel Bryan.
Daniel Bryan, who was involved in a great matchup last night, best 2 out of 3 falls versus Sheamus for the world championship, has a golden opportunity here tonight. Well, it's one of the most anticipated pay-per-views of the year. And for the first time ever, it comes to Phoenix in July. Money in the Bank. Tickets are available on Friday. Money in the Bank, where champions are born. And ironically, the place where this man, Daniel Bryan's career was launched last year when he won the Money in the Bank ladder match. He would later cash it in for the world title. And who's his opponent going to be? Well, that's why my partner left here during the commercial break. I'm glad he filled me in on what was going on here tonight.
WWE Hall of Famer, Jerry the King Lawler.
I don't think anybody saw this coming. Jerry the King Lawler with an opportunity to beat the clock against this man, the former world champion, Daniel Bryan. Either Lawler or Bryan must beat the 4 minutes and 16 seconds of Randy Orton to have an opportunity at the WWE title against CM Punk. And what a dream this would be for Jerry Lawler to knock off Daniel Bryan here tonight and get another opportunity at the WWE Championship. Clock is running, under 4:10 to go, and Daniel Bryan realizing he's got a great opportunity here, unloading on Lawler, but he can't get disqualified. Bryan's got to be careful, he's not disqualified. And Bryan right up to the jaw of Lawler. Bryan quickly into the cover, just under 4 minutes in. The King kicks out at 2. Jerry Lawler, who had his only opportunity at the WWE Championship last year. If he beats the clock tonight, would have the second of his career. And here comes the King. Those patented right-hand punches. Unloading on Bryan, who uses a headbutt. And a snap there by the submission specialist. Again, a cover as he glances at the clock. And we're down under 3.5 minutes. It almost seems like Bryan is surprised that Lawler has lasted this long. Over a minute now in the matchup. Again a cover and again a kick out by Lawler. Randy Orton, the Viper, looking on. He has set the pace, set the time to be here tonight. Can Lawler pull a huge monumental upset tonight? Or will Bryan be able to beat the clock? Or will it be Orton who advances? Patented drop kick on the jaw, and Lawler into the cover. Jerry Lawler looking to do it, and it's Bryan who kicks out under 3 minutes to go. And nobody home! And the clock continues to tick. 2:35. Lawler's gonna go up to the second rope. Bryan's in trouble. Jerry Lawler pulling the strap down. What a major victory. What an upset. Connects with the fist. Here's the cover. Lawler's going to do it, and Bryan kicks out. Lawler thought he had Daniel Bryan there. Uh-oh. Lawler with 2:12 going for the pile driver. And it was Bryan who countered. And now Daniel Bryan with a kick to the head. And Lawler, he could be unconscious. And right in the position for Daniel Bryan to lock in the yes lock. The submission maneuver. Lawler's got no choice but to tap out. Daniel Bryan beat the clock. Daniel Bryan.
And the beat the clock challenge, Daniel Bryan.
And that means Daniel Bryan in 3 weeks heads to Over the Limit in Raleigh, North Carolina. He will face CM Punk for the WWE Championship. Daniel Bryan beats the clock here tonight on Monday Night Raw. And the celebration has begun for Daniel Bryan. And there's the WWE Champion CM Punk. Punk welcoming the challenge. And I, for one, am looking forward to this matchup in 3 weeks at Over the Limit. Two great technical wrestlers putting the championship on the line. CM Punk defending against Daniel Bryan.
Yes! 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 Yes. 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 Yes.
Well, you can't blame Daniel Bryan for being upset over the fact that Sheamus, well, stole his signature phrase.
He stole something else. He stole that title away from him, baby.
Well, here we go. Again, it was all psychological, I guess, on Sheamus's point, but nonetheless, Daniel Bryan not happy.
Yeah, we kick things off here on Friday Night SmackDown. The world champion Sheamus one-on-one with the former world champion Daniel Bryan. Daniel Bryan obviously upset that he didn't win back the world championship, but that sort of was, helped a little bit this past Monday night.
But again, what an extraordinary matchup here tonight. Booker to kick things off on SmackDown, a return match from what happened this past Sunday at Extreme Rules, and an opportunity for Daniel Bryan to prove that he can indeed beat Sheamus.
Let me tell you something. Daniel Bryan went out there Sunday night, Extreme Rules, and just let it all hang out. The kid actually went to the limit, almost pulled it out. Sheamus just had a little bit more, dog.
And again, Daniel Bryan looking to get after the injured shoulder of Sheamus as a result of their match this past Sunday at Extreme Rules.
Oh, look at this.
Nice takedown.
And Daniel Bryan looked like he was going to go for the yes lock there. Both of these men know so much about one another.
Did you see that right hand right there, baby?
And another one. Sheamus not going to take this lion down.
Just the pure power and strength of the world champion,
oh,
Daniel Bryan.
Oh, my goodness. That's what I'm talking about. Real dangerous, this kid right here, D. Bryan.
Sheamus is in trouble as Daniel Bryan has targeted the injured arm of Sheamus.
Okay, this right here, this is called competition right here at its finest.
Well, remember, guys, remember what happened Sunday at Extreme Rules. Daniel Bryan applying that yes lock to the point where Sheamus actually passed out in the middle of the ring.
You know, at one point, I thought the referee was just going to have to step in and stop it.
Daniel Bryan continues to systematically dissect Sheamus.
Well, Daniel Bryan making it a point earlier this week that he wanted this rematch tonight against Sheamus. He wanted to continue to injure the arm and punish Sheamus like he's doing here.
Let me tell you, just looking at Daniel Bryan tonight, it ain't no playing, no jiving, just business. That's what I'm talking about.
Daniel Bryan, of course, the number one contender for the WWE Championship after he beat the clock this past Monday night on Raw. He'll face CM Punk in a couple of weeks at Over the Limit.
Talking about a contest, I cannot wait to see that.
Well, right now, Daniel Bryan fully focused on the task at hand, and that is Sheamus. An explosive start here to Friday Night SmackDown.
Oh, what a right, Sheamus.
Ooh.
Just going right back to that little soft spot.
Yeah, but look at Sheamus fighting back as well.
Let me tell you, if he wants a fight tonight, he's going to get one. Just check it out. This guy's rolling.
Unloading on Daniel Bryan. Plumbing blows.
Sheamus unleashed.
Referee had to jump in there for a second.
Well, doing his job, but Sheamus been relentless.
Oh, my goodness. Ooh. That big running knee lift right there, dog.
And Daniel Bryan all the way to the floor.
What the referee's doing?
What the?
Who the? Is that?
What the hell?
Rodriguez and Del Rio. And Alberto Del Rio.
This right here, dog, this is a monkey.
Cross-armbreaker!
This is a monkey right
here! Cross-armbreaker!
Somebody better stop him! He's gonna break it!
Yeah, on the already injured arm of Sheamus!
Oh, man, he's gonna break it! Oh, my goodness!
And now look at Daniel Bryan!
The yes-lock! The yes-lock from Daniel Bryan!
Referee, for God's sake, do something about this!
First the cross-armbreaker, now the yes-lock! Sheamus being punished, the world champion being punished. Well, Alberto Del Rio is the number one contender for Sheamus' world title. Daniel Bryan obviously upset with Del Rio. Maybe Daniel Bryan thought he had Sheamus here tonight.
Sheamus is in some serious pain.
Take this kid.
Oh man, knees straight to the face and shoulder. Sheamus is physical as they come.
Sheamus just took it to the limit right there. Referee almost had to get involved.
And now Daniel Bryan. Look at Daniel Bryan here.
Look out, Sheamus.
You know, this may be a match that Sheamus never recovers from, guys.
Huge drop kick right to the shoulder. This has to do it. Sheamus, it's over now.
Yeah. Remember, Daniel Bryan made the challenge tonight, and Sheamus accepted it.
And that was a 2.5 count right there, something that normally never happens when you got Sheamus on his back.
Shock in the eyes of Daniel Bryan has now turned.
And Sheamus isn't moving, guys. Look at him. Sheamus is hurt. Real hurt. Doing his job, getting Daniel Bryan away from Sheamus.
Just turned that boy inside out. Dropped him.
Barata. Sheamus.
The hill.
And it's Del Rio.
And Daniel Bryan.
Yeah, Bryan was going for the yes. Oh man.
Hello.
Del Rio retreating. Look up. Look out. Daniel Bryan. Daniel Bryan. Up top.
Oh, no.
Broken.
Broken.
That boy going to need some dental work after that. Man, I can't believe he put it up like that.
Sheamus.
Well, that's what Alberto Del Rio is going to be facing in 2 weeks.
Sheamus is a man among men. You got to love it.
Assaulted as we kicked off Friday Night SmackDown by Alberto Del Rio. And then Daniel Bryan says, I'm going to compete. Sheamus did so, victorious here tonight over Daniel Bryan.
Sheamus said it. He said he loved the fight, and he was rolling. And he just turned that boy, Daniel Bryan, inside out with that double axe handle.
But Alberto Del Rio would get involved. Sheamus! We'll take care of this situation with Del Rio quickly.
Well, watch this, guys. Watch Sheamus. Boom! To the jaw.
Just that one, man. Look at it.
Watch the impact.
Daniel Bryan going to need a whole lot of dental work after this one right here, son. You can count to 100. It's over.
A very impressive victory here tonight for Sheamus.
Sheamus came here to fight tonight. And fight he did.
You're gonna know it, and you're gonna love it.
Well, very plausible explanation. Well, there's the WWE Champion, CM Punk. And hopefully, CM Punk will come out here and say a lot of things that I'm sure everyone in this arena is thinking right now. Oh, so you're expecting CM Punk to drop a, quote, pipe bomb tonight? Don't be surprised. CM Punk in a couple of weeks and Over the Limit will take on Daniel Bryan for the WWE Championship. Gonna be interesting to hear Punk's take on the explanation offered us moments ago by the general manager, Mr. Laurinaitis. We'll be right back.
You never seem to really amaze anybody. You never cease to amaze me. For somebody as bold as you to claim to be the genius behind this whole people power movement, you still haven't a clue as to what these people actually want. You don't know what these people want to hear. You don't know what these people want to see. But don't worry. I'm out here today. I'm on your side. I'm going to help you. Now, I'm not going to make it easy. I'm not just going to hand you the keys to the castle, okay? I'm not just going to tell you what they want to hear. I'm not going to tell you exactly what they want to see. We're going to start backwards, and we'll work our way to the top. I'm going to tell you what they don't want to hear and what they don't want to see. And what the WWE Universe doesn't want to see is you. You hear that? They don't want to see you week in and week out shuffling around in your Brooks Brothers suits with your personal agendas and your bucket list. And they don't want to hear about the time you spent in Japan. I especially love the revisionist history about how good you really were. That was awesome. But I know the truth, and I like to tell the truth. And maybe I'm that guy that says things to people that other people just don't want to say. So I'm going to here to tell you to your face, straight up, all of this is about you putting your chips on Brock Lesnar, and then John Cena beat him. So your face turned as red as your Republican tie, and you got embarrassed. And then you attack an already injured John Cena. What, to let out your frustrations? You're like a little hyena. Brock Lesnar does the damage, and then you're here the next night to pick the bones. Am I forgetting anything? You think, am I forgetting any? Oh, yeah, I forgot. The reason you had to go compete in Japan is because there wasn't a territory or a person in, a single one, that would pay a dime to see your rotten ass wrestle. You were a joke then, and you left, and you came back, and you're still a joke.
Be very careful, Punk. Be very careful.
I'll be careful. I'll be careful, Mr. Rooney. And another thing I'm going to do is watch the pay-per-view. The same pay-per-view over the limit. When I beat Daniel Bryan, I'm going to watch John Cena beat you.
Are you finished?
Am I finished? See, that's people power. We're going to listen to the people right now. Am I finished? All right, let's see then. You're stupid? You're ugly? And you have no friends? Am I finished? You're also a gigantic toolbox. There. Now I'm finished.
You know what, Punk? If I was in training for my match with Cena right now, I'd pummel you down to the ground. But you know what? Since you want it tonight, you're gonna face somebody who knows the word respect. You're gonna face somebody who went to Japan, honed their skills, and came back as a destructive force. You wanna be taught a lesson? Well, tonight you will. Tonight, you will face Lord Tenzai.
You know, I had a feeling you were gonna do that, given your entire career. You've hid behind extremely talented big men, and you've had other people your entire life do all your heavy lifting. That's fine. I look forward to the challenge, pal, almost as much as I look forward to Over the Limit watching John Cena twist you into a pretzel and watch you tap out.
Look out, Punk. Oh, we've seen this before. There's a green mist that causes vision impairment in the claw. With a powerful claw planting CM Punk. Shoulders are down. Tensai in leads him to his clash with Punk in 2 weeks at Over the Limit for the championship. Out at Tensai is impressive each and every week. That claw's been unstoppable. Check it out. I think that CM Punk had it well in hand, but then Daniel Bryan from the floor, putting Punk down and ends up, well, that green mist. Ah. That claw to the face. Tensai, watch this, powerful.
Yes! Yes! One, two, three!
Look at now, Daniel Bryan. Punk trying to recover from the attack by Tensai, and now the number one contender for Punk's title. Oh, look out. And the Yes Lock. The Yes Lock is locked in. CM Punk feeling the effects of the Yes Lock. Daniel Bryan sending a clear message to the champion.
The match is over.
I'll tell you, Bryan locks that Yes Lock in. It's over. And over the limit.
That's enough. Come on.
And Bryan again going for the Yes Lock. Well, again, this is a lesson, ladies and gentlemen, to all WWE superstars tonight. You disrespect Mr. Laurinaitis, there will be severe consequences. You cannot challenge Mr. Laurinaitis' authority.
And we are back here on Friday Night SmackDown.
Move over, AJ! Caitlin's my upgrade!
What a snake.
Smiles after all.
Look at this guy. Just look at him. You're talking about a snake.
Humiliating ex-girlfriend AJ again publicly.
He's moving up in the world. And he's proud of it. Daniel Bryan could very well be humiliated right now against the world's largest athlete, The Big Show.
Well, remember how Daniel Bryan became World Heavyweight Champion here on SmackDown. Bryan would cash in his Money in the Bank contract on a prone Big Show. Daniel Bryan, that's how things really got started last year for Daniel Bryan.
It happened back in December at the TLC pay-per-view. Big Show beat Mark Henry to become the world champion. Mark Henry then assaulted Big Show. Daniel Bryan would come out, take advantage, cash in the contract. Big Show was champion for just 45 seconds.
And now Big Show closing in on Daniel Bryan. Booker, remember how embarrassed Big Show was at the hands of Bryan.
Definitely was embarrassed, but right now is a huge chance to get some payback. Just come out here and just rag-tag this boy, Daniel. Did you see that smile just melt away on Daniel Bryan when he saw this giant?
Well, Daniel Bryan, a huge opportunity to win the WWE Championship a week from Sunday over the limit in Raleigh, North Carolina, when he takes on CM Punk. Bryan earning that opportunity when he beat the clock a couple of weeks ago on Monday Night Raw.
And Daniel Bryan would grab some more momentum this past Monday night. The Big Show now down to one knee.
Oh my goodness. Let me tell you something. No doubt Daniel Bryan has all the skills and all the technique to go in there and come out WWE champion. I just want to see if he's going to get it done.
Oh, and wow. Whoa. Daniel Bryan wisely taking out the knee of the Big Show. The Giant now down.
That's what I'm talking about as far as Daniel Bryan, the technique of this guy right here. He's tactical. I mean, he's got all the skills and knows every inch of that square circle.
And look at Daniel Bryan. He can be vicious like a little pit bull.
Daniel Bryan now.
Yeah, look at this.
The Yes Lock.
Oh, man, he's going for it early. Hey. What the hell?
Wait.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match by submission, Daniel Bryan.
Oh, hell no.
Why? Well, I thought I saw Big Show tapping out. I thought I saw Big Show
Big
tapping
Show didn't
out.
Big Show tap out. What are you talking
well,
about?
Well, our general manager, John Laurinaitis, saw it happen
look,
right here.
I don't know what monitor you watching, but Big Show did not tap.
Well, Daniel Bryan hightailing it out of here with a suspect victory.
suspect.
Punk and Santino Marella, and Punk wants some revenge tonight after what Daniel Bryan did to him. We showed you the footage before the commercial break, the yes lock after the matchup last week.
Well, Daniel Bryan, I think he's going for a jerk of a lifetime.
So CM Punk will start things off with the Intercontinental Champion Cody Rhodes, although Punk seems to feel like he'd rather have Daniel Bryan in the ring.
Can you blame him?
Cody Rhodes, who before losing the Intercontinental Championship at WrestleMania, had one of the longest Intercontinental title reigns of all time. He won the title again back at Extreme Rules in a tables match versus The Big Show.
So Cody Rhodes has millions of dollars worth of talent and Santino.
Exactly. That's
I wish I could buy Cody Rhodes for what he's worth and then sell him for what he thinks he's worth.
Well, there's no doubt. Can't question the talent of Cody Rhodes, the current Intercontinental Champion, as Punk continues to stare at Daniel Bryan. A very prestigious Intercontinental title held by more than a dozen WWE Hall of Famers. The likes of Pat Patterson and Don Morocco and Bret Hart, Edge, Stone Cold Steve Austin. Cody Rhodes says that he's in their class.
Yeah. Well, that's Cody Rhodes talking. Saw CM Punk literally throw Cody Rhodes right into the corner over there. Daniel Bryan would not tag.
Daniel Bryan's picking his spots. He knows he's got Punk for the title on Sunday.
CM Punk ran right into that big boot from Cody Rhodes.
And Cody Rhodes and CM Punk hanging on. Here comes Cody, sent through the second rope by the WWE Champion. And Daniel Bryan from behind, set for the ride by Punk.
Great. It was a meeting of the minds, not the way they wanted it, but
what does Santino want to do here? Santino a fry short of a Happy Meal. And the last Punk taking out Bryan and Rhodes.
Santino had a good idea. Well, don't tell me he's going to try it. Wait a minute, Santino. I don't know if it's a good idea.
The United States Champion didn't quite work out that way. This guy's a goof.
What do you mean?
But Punk and Santino are in control. Can a frustrated Bryan and Rhodes get back in this when Raw returns live? We are back live on Monday Night Raw. The Intercontinental Champion Cody Rhodes being dominated here by the United States Champion Santino. This is a tag team matchup. There's CM Punk, Santino's partner, and of course Daniel Bryan is teaming with, can you believe this?
He's teaming with Cody Rhodes.
Yeah, but look at this. This is ridiculous.
CM Punk, what do you mean? What's
CM Punk's, it's clobbering time. It's trending worldwide. What is the matter with these people that tweet? That is ridiculous. It's clobbering time.
Yeah, it's time for CM Punk to clobber Daniel Bryan.
Please.
That's what they want to
see. You probably tweeted that to a trend too, didn't you? It's clobbering time. Now Santino, the United States Champion, runs right into a right hand of the Intercontinental Champion Cody Rhodes, and Daniel Bryan, number one contender for the WWE title, comes in off the tag.
Oh yeah, he wants in there now. And Santino's down flat on his back.
Oh, and Bryan! Kick to the jaw. Santino's in trouble, and Bryan's staring right back at the man he meets Sunday at Over the Limit, CM Punk. Here's the cover, shoulders down, and a kick out in two by Santino. Great article on WWE.com. Tremendous read about the history between Daniel Bryan and CM Punk. So much I didn't know about the history between these two as Daniel Bryan continues. Now he hooks the leg, shoulders down, and a kick out again by Santino at two. And Punk realizes his partner's in deep trouble as Rhodes comes in off the tag.
Watch these continuous knees to the chest and throat of Santino.
Listen to these people. Ooh.
You know, I do realize that yes is the favorite word.
That's him.
Everybody's favorite word in the entire vocabulary. But I think they're stretching a little bit. Every move that Daniel Bryan says, we're going to react with a yes.
Very forceful cover by Cody Rhodes. Why not?
Oh, I'm sure you would say why not. I remember when you thought Daniel Bryan was the biggest goof on earth. Now you're on the bandwagon, aren't you?
Well, he's a winner. I support winners. He won me over.
Well, he may be a winner, but he's going to be the challenger, and he's going against the WWE champion. Why aren't you behind CM Punk? He's obviously a winner.
Because I think Daniel Bryan's going to be the next champ in just 6 nights. And he continues to wear Santino down. The United States champion, Santino, in a world of hurt here. Daniel Bryan, the submission specialist.
I respect your opinion, even though mine's better.
Santino trying to make it to the bottom rope to break this hold here. I've said it before about Daniel Bryan. He is like a pit bull. Relentless. And Santino tries to battle back at Bryan once again. Riding kicks to Santino and Rhodes in off the tag.
Great tag team work between Cody Rhodes and Daniel Bryan.
Oh, it's just marvelous. Yeah, they're keeping successfully keeping Santino away from his partner CM Punk. And you're right, that is good tag team strategy.
Wow.
Forehand with a knee.
Cody would love to knock off Santino here. Santino's been doing a lot of bragging as of late, claiming that his United States championship is more important than the Intercontinental title. Cody says the otherwise.
You got it all wrong. He's not bragging. This young man is proud. Have you?
So then why do you say Cody Rhodes is bragging about being the Intercontinental champion?
Because Cody Rhodes is arrogant. Santino is not arrogant. Santino is humble.
Double team.
Look at this double team.
Saw Daniel Bryan go to the corner. Trash talk Punk, which allowed the double team.
There
Santino! Trying to make a tag, didn't quite get there. And Cody Rhodes is laughing at the miscue by Santino.
Santino came short. Look at this. There's the tag.
Yeah, WWE champion. CM Punk get off the tag. And CM Punk firing up.
And Cody Rhodes is not laughing right now. Nice.
Hail kick to the jaw by Punk. And every time he delivers an offensive maneuver, he stares at Daniel Bryan. The man he meets Sunday. And over the limit. That one's for you, Bryan, Punk says.
There you go. Come on in, Daniel Bryan, get you some.
Punk says it's time for Cody Rhodes to go to sleep.
Watch out here.
Not quite yet. Oh, what a kick! That might knock Rhodes out.
Wow.
Punk and Daniel Bryan. Daniel Bryan in trouble. And Bryan hightailing it. And look at Santino in the corner.
Watch out. Watch out, Punk from behind.
Cody Rhodes looking to capitalize, see a punt from behind. Uh-oh, Cobra went to strike. Cody Rhodes avoiding the Cobra, runs in to go to sleep. Punk hooks the leg. Will that be the fate of Daniel Bryan come Sunday?
And speaking of Daniel Bryan, look where he was. When the three count was made.
The team of Santino Ladder and CM Punk.
Daniel Bryan had already turned tail and ran.
Yes, lock? No, absolutely, absolutely not.
Punk. Hey.
Hey. Good luck with that one.
Yeah. Thanks. Remember that 50 you owe me. Hi. What's up?
Hey. I just wanted to say. I just wanted to say. Good luck on Sunday.
I appreciate that. Thanks. But don't take this the wrong way. I don't want to get involved. In between you and your boyfriend or your ex-boyfriend or whatever it is you two are, I don't need the drama. I've known Daniel Bryan a long time. I don't trust him. I don't want you to think that I think this is a setup or anything like that, but I don't trust him. And you I've known a very short amount of time, and in that time you've been pretty unstable. So, you know, I'll see you later.
Don't you get it, Johnny? I mean, I'm not even a praying guy, and I've been praying. Everybody here in this arena has been praying. All the superstars backstage, everybody around the world has been praying. I'm here to let you know that our prayers have been answered. This Sunday, the only way you win is by pinfall or submission. If anybody interferes on your behalf, they get terminated. Now, you're all alone. It's just one-on-one. The best part is when, not if, but when John Cena beats you. You get terminated! And then, allow me to be the first one to wish you best of luck on your future endeavors. We're going to be partying in the streets. We're going to kick it off on Monday Night Raw, and it's going to continue all the way to next Friday right here on SmackDown. We're going to throw a party that's going to be bigger than Mardi Gras. I mean, do you have any idea how miserable you make people? Do you have any idea how much you've abused your power? I'll take you back to Monday Night Raw. You had a 7-foot-tall giant on his knees in tears, groveling for your forgiveness. You made him beg for his job because he loves entertaining all of you. You made him beg for his job, and you did it with a smile on your face. Sort of like this one. You constantly insult the intelligence of the great WWE universe. You're out of touch. You belittle and humiliate Teddy Long, somebody who's made SmackDown the great show that it is. So I gotta ask, how's it feel? How's it feel to be on the other end of the stick for once?
Punk, I'm not there yet. I'm still the general manager of Raw and SmackDown, and I can do what I want, and I can make any match I want. So tonight, you're gonna face one-on-one Kane.
Okay, I'm not gonna pretend that I'm not concerned that I'm facing Kane, but I'm also not gonna run to the board of directors and ask out of the match because I'm a man. And the funny thing about it all is when it comes to Kane, I respect him, which is more than I can say for you. This time next week, I'll still be WWE champion. And you'll be hanging out in the unemployment line.
Now, good luck with Kane tonight, Punk.
CM Punk, always very defiant, always very outspoken,
telling Mr. Laurinaitis how it's going to go down Sunday.
Let me just say how it is. It was very disrespectful on the part of CM Punk. John Laurinaitis is going through a tremendous amount of stuff in his life right now.
John Laurinaitis,
you all kidding me, right, Cole?
He's got a family to feed. Oh, Laurinaitis has been traumatized. The board of directors has turned on him. He's trying to send kids to college.
You like that, don't you? I can't hear you. You like that, right? You like it when somebody makes fun of their boss. Since I've been general manager of Raw and SmackDown, I've been tough but fair. I've sometimes been generous. I've been benevolent. But you don't get it, do you? I work hard for you, the WWE Universe. And it seems like the harder I work, the more you like the crap all over me. Now, I'm not going to blame John Cena and CM Punk for their actions. I'm going to blame each and every one of you. You support what they do. You support what they say. It's your fault. I detest each and every one of you. You. And if this is my last night on SmackDown, I want all you ingrates to remember the last thing I say. You can all go to hell.
WWE title.
It's always about putting yourself in a great position, and that's what D. Bryant has done since stepping up to the plate. Right now, looking forward to capturing the holy grail of professional sports.
You see Zack Ryder writhing in pain here as Daniel Bryan, he's such a submission expert, can wear you down in so many different ways.
He told me once he knows over 100 submission maneuvers, can make you tap 100 different ways.
Check out D. Bryant right there with that clothesline.
Check out Long Island IC.
Yeah, let's not forget Zack Ryder, former United States champion.
Like I say, Zack Ryder got a whole lot of talent, but he loved entertaining the fans a little bit more. That's what I like about this kid, Zack Ryder.
And Ryder, who's celebrating a birthday in his sweep, was going for the broski boot, got countered there by Daniel Bryan.
Just waiting a little bit too much time. You can't play with this boy, D. Bryant, like that right there.
Oh, man. Ryder may be out cold.
That's it.
And now the yes lock.
Oh, we're about to go to school, son.
Ryder forced to tap out.
And giving the yes lock on a little bit extra time. Perhaps sending a message to the WWE Champion CM Punk. Guys, if Daniel Bryan locks in the yes lock on Sunday, I think we're going to see a new WWE champ. CM Punk taking out Kane.
CM Punk.
Hey, whoa.
What the hell is he doing?
Daniel Bryan.
Hey, put the chair down now.
Struck him.
Oh.
And now with a chair to the damaged midsection. And Kane is wearing out the champion.
Look at the smile on the face of Daniel Bryan.
What a strategy by that boy, D. Bryant.
So calculated.
Kane is incensed.
Daniel Bryant. CM Punk injured ribs and all. He was damaged even before the steel chair shots from Kane. And now the big red monster continues the attack as Daniel Bryan, who set all this up, looks on.
I just said, is CM Punk going to make it to Over the Limit Sunday night?
By Kane.
Kane. Oh, my God.
Don't get the WWE champion here.
Kane continuing to assault the champion. Daniel Bryan is loving it. And, guys, whether you agree with it or you don't, there is no doubt that Daniel Bryan's strategy tonight was foolproof and definitely put them in the driver's seat with a WWE title on the line Sunday.
Let me tell you, it was diabolical by that boy, D. Bryan. But let me tell you something. It was good.